I am suspicious of the narrative that we've become accustomed to over the past century.
They recently released an incredible three-dimensional scan of the shipwreck of the Titanic. I mean, look at it. It's absolutely amazing. Just one problem that I have with this whole thing. Where is the sideswipe damage that was supposedly to have occurred from that iceberg that sank the ship?
A complete 3D reconstruction of the shipwreck of the Titanic was released last week. And it reveals the ship like we've never seen it before. The Titanic has been extensively explored since the wreck was discovered by Dr. Robert Ballard in 1985. But it's so huge that in the gloom of the deep, cameras can only ever show us teasing snapshots of the decaying ship. Never the whole thing. Books have been written, documentaries have been produced.
Right ahead.
And of course, movies have been made detailing the catastrophic effects of an iceberg scraping along the starboard side of the Titanic. A gouge that breaches more watertight compartments than the ship could sustain in order to stay afloat. This 3D scan took over 200 hours of dive time to complete. It was assembled from more than 700,000 images taken from every conceivable angle. Now, of course, the beginning portion of that iceberg damage will be concealed by the muddy bottom built up around the bow of the ship as it collided with the ocean floor at a speed of more than 30 miles per hour. That all makes sense, and it accounts for why we can't see the initial impact point of the iceberg. But here's my problem with the whole thing. According to witness statements, the hull breach extended along the starboard side of the ship, past boiler room 5 and boiler room 6. Plus, we can see the shading of the red oxide paint from the very bottom of the ship, right here. Combine those two facts, and in my mind, there can only be one conclusion. That iceberg did not scrape the side of the ship as we have been led to believe for over 100 years. So, what does this 3D scan now tell us?
I am suspicious of the narrative that we've become accustomed to over the past century.
Park Stephenson is a world-renowned expert on the Titanic. He's dived multiple times on the wreck of Titanic and served as technical advisor to James Cameron, director of the movie Titanic. Parks has also appeared multiple times with us on the video podcast Museum Ship Mafia. And lately, he has been conducting interviews with worldwide news agencies like the BBC and CNN nonstop. Because with the recent release of this 3D scan of the Titanic, history as we know it when it comes to the sinking of this ship may have changed.
I basically question whether or not Titanic hit the iceberg along the side, as we've all come to accept nowadays. I'm seeing a growing amount of evidence in recent years that suggests that Titanic actually grounded, ran over a submerged shelf of the iceberg, which was the first scenario proposed back in April 1912, but soon got buried under this, 300-foot gash torn out of the bottom, and then that turned into the bumping along the side that we've all seen today.
What we see of an iceberg on the ocean is a small fraction of its overall size. As the saying goes, it's just the tip of the iceberg. The majority of an iceberg lies underwater, unseen to those on the surface. This is one of several photographs taken of the iceberg that Titanic hit. It doesn't appear to be that big, does it? But when you consider what it must look like under the surface of the Atlantic Ocean, suddenly, Park Stephenson's theory makes sense. Without any evidence of a 300-foot-long gouge or scrape along the starboard side of Titanic, there must have been some feature of the iceberg underwater that ripped open a gash much closer to the bottom of Titanic, which explains why we cannot see the evidence of an impact with an iceberg in any of these 3D scanned images of Titanic.